Welcome back to my channel. So for today's video, I'm gonna be doing what's in my hospital bag, and I'm gonna be basically just showing you guys what I'm taking to the hospital for myself and for the baby. So if you want to know what I'm taking to the hospital, just keep on watching. As of today, I am 35 weeks and a half, and I basically just want to start getting things ready. I have most of the things that I'm going to take to the hospital, just some things that I need to put as I get closer, or like that same moment. So yeah. Okay, so first I'm gonna start with the baby stuff. This is my diaper bag. I got it at Target. I'm gonna try to link everything in the description box. Hope you guys can't hear my dog snoring. So for the first thing, it's his portrait outfit. Usually with my past kids, they would go and take like the newborn pictures, so we could later on purchase it online or whatever, but I don't know how it's going on with the pandemic, so I'm still taking it. I don't know if they are still doing it or not, but this is his little outfit. We have the underwear with the little hat. We have the dino shoes. And his little stuffy. So this outfit, I got it from someone on Instagram. Her name is Maida V Science 79. I'll link the description down below. Okay, the next thing is I am taking some newborn Pampers that was given to me during my baby shower, just because at the hospital, the experiences that I have the last two times is that they only carry a size 1. I don't like for the Pamper to be touching or covering the little umbilical cord, which the newborns usually have the little pocket for it. So I'm taking these. The next item is the letter board. I started it, but obviously I don't know if he's gonna be born in November or December, so I just put it there and I'll just be changing whatever I need to change. But I'm taking it just to take some pictures of my own to do the baby announcement. And this one was also given to me on my baby shower, but I'll try to find something and put it in the description for you guys. The next thing I'm taking are some burp cuffs. I got 3, just in case there's any accidents like puke or whatever. So for the hospital, I'm also taking 2 swaddle blankets. It's with the matching gorrito, and obviously it's dinosaurs. I usually, once I have the baby, I usually always have it with whatever clothes and blankets I bring from home. It could look super cute. So yeah, just so that I could be comfortable with the baby in its own clothes. I tend to, they tend to just put like an undershirt, and usually like that one's really big because they don't know like sizes or whatever. So it's like a one size fits all. And so yeah, my babies are always like super, they're long pero delgaditos, so it fits super big on them. So yeah, I take my own clothes just so that they could be a little bit more comfortable and so that I could feel like They don't feel super cold or anything. The second swaddle blanket is... Okay, so the next swaddle blanket, it's this gray with stripes, and this is a gorrito. This was a present from my mom. I have a matching robe, which I'm also taking to the hospital. Super cute. We're going to be matching. So, yeah. Thank you, Mom. The reason why I'm only taking two blankets is because I'm also taking this swaddle. This swaddle sack, which I believe I had already shown it to you guys during one of my bump box unboxing. You could cover them up so they won't hurt themselves, so like gloves. And it's a little costalito, it's closed from the bottom. And you just zip it and unzip it to put the baby in and out and change the pampers. It opens through the bottom. So you could just change the pamper and not like uncover them all. And then just so that they could feel nice and hugged, you can, or you put this one. And I included the instructions for the swaddle sack, just in case I forget. So I'm also taking like undershirts for the baby to be wearing under the swaddles. I'm taking this one, and this one. And these three are newborn. And I am taking three of these just in case, because there tend to be poop accidents or whatever. And then I'm also taking this one, which is also newborn, but it's a little bit bigger than the other ones. I'm taking gloves, baby gloves. I'm taking this gray one for this gray swaddle blanket. And I'll put it inside the gorritos just so it won't get lost. I'm taking this blue one for the swaddle blanket that has the dinos. I'm also taking two outfits to go home. My first outfit is this newborn onesie that I really liked. And it comes with the little hat, and I'm putting the black gloves, and I'm taking the matching socks. So that's for outfit one. Also, if I haven't used it, I'll be putting this onesie underneath. Okay, so for outfit number two, it's this cute little shirt, and then it's this little pants with that comes already with the little botitas on, and the matching gorrito with some gray gloves. And I'm also taking these little pair of socks. I don't know if I'm going to be putting on the socks or not, just depending. Okay, my mom called. So I'm taking the bottle, and I'm also planning on taking a breast pump. I know, at least at my hospital, if you are having problems breastfeeding, you can ask for a breast pump and they'll give you like one manually. But I do have an electronic one from my previous pregnancies. Deliveries. So I am taking it with me. I just don't have it with me right now. So I need to go and get it. It's like stored in the storage. So I need to go get it, clean it, disinfect it, and probably take it with me. Or have it in the car just in case I do need it or not. Oh yeah, I'm also taking the breastfeeding pillow. It's really good for before you deliver, just so you could feel comfortable. And obviously after, so you could be able to breastfeed, it's a little bit more comfortable. So yeah, I'm taking it with me. And I'm also taking a blanket. This is a blanket for the baby, just so when we leave, so he could be nice and warm inside his car seat. On the car seat, I did purchase the car seat covers. It's just a little cover for the car seat so that it could be warm. And then it also has, basically it's like a blanket that you strap it on the car seat holder or grabber, and then it's just covering the baby. But in the inside, I'll be having this one so that the baby could be tucked in and warm. Just para que no le entre aire, since it is going to be a November/December baby, and I don't really know how cold it's going to be. So I'm just preparing in case. Okay, so I have the blanket on this bag. I don't know if I'm just going to take the blanket like that, but for sure I want to take this this bag so that I could put my dirty clothes in there for after when we're leaving. That is it for the baby stuff. Okay, so this is my hospital bag, or at least one of them. So the first thing is I'm taking some Germex. I am taking 3 snacks to help breastfeed. I got like a huge box at Target. These are the Milk Makers Lactation Cookie Bites. And it is, the ingredients are traditionally used to support breast milk supply. They are oatmeal chocolate chip cookies. And the brand is Munchkin. And they also have teas and a lot of, like, I think also granola bars. A lot of stuff to help breastfeeding. So I only bought the cookies for now, but I am planning on going and buying the rest of the stuff. I just focus on the cookies because you tend to get hungry. And it's just easier, like when you're at the hospital, just to be eating cookies instead of making tea or whatever. I don't know how often I'm going to eat them, but just in case. I'll probably take 6. Right now I have 3, but I'm probably going to take 6 overall. So yeah, take some snacks because you tend to do get a little bit more hungry and thirsty when you're breastfeeding. And it helps your milk supply. Okay, the next thing I'm taking are the slippers for, these are waterproof, so they're like for the shower. And I think I'm just gonna wear these on when I'm going to the hospital, and that way those are the only shoes I'm taking in and out. Just so I won't be carrying like too many shoes. So yeah, I'm taking these on to the hospital, and I'll use them there, and also when I'm leaving I'll be taking these. And these are my socks that I'm taking. I'm just taking one pair of cozy socks so that whenever I'm leaving, since I am wearing slippers, no quiero agarrar like aire. So I'm going to be wearing these on me. The next thing is one of my fajas. I'm gonna be taking this one. This one is by Jahaira, and you can find her on Instagram. I made a video from this one a while ago. I still have it. This one is a size medium. I think I might need to purchase a smaller one, but I don't want to purchase, or I didn't want to purchase anything right now until I know the size that I'm going to be needing. Because I don't know if I'm going to be going into a small or maybe an extra small. Since these do stretch, I want to go like smaller than whatever size I am. But yeah, I'm taking this one to the hospital just so after delivery, I am going to be putting this one on just to make sure everything stays in place and things don't get like messy. So I'm taking undies. I'm taking three undies. This one is like a faja kind of underwear. Then the second one is a black one. And this one is another black one. I'm not sure if I'm going to be using them or not, but I'm just taking it just in case. Sometimes you bleed a lot and sometimes you don't. So if I notice that I'm not bleeding a lot, I'll be wearing the underwears with the pads. I was going to take some pads, but I'm not taking any because at my hospital they do give you some. So in case I do wear the underwears, I'll be putting the pads on. And I'm also taking these Pampers. These are size small medium. They're maximum and they come with, I bought the 12 pack. I'm taking six, basically like three for each day. This is what they look like. So the plan is that if I do have a heavy flow, I'll be wearing this. And just to make sure that, since this is a small medium, I'm not sure if I'm a small or if I'm going to be a small medium or extra small. So since I got the small medium, just in case if it's a little bit big, since I've never worn any of these, this is why I have the shorts faja, just to make sure that this stays in place and it's not like moving around. And again, just because you don't want to be super tight right after delivery, but you don't want to be just loose because you do feel like if things are moving, basically your organs and everything are moving back into place, so you do need a little bit of support. So the next thing I have is my little baggie. Okay, I have toothbrush and toothpaste. I'm taking a brush for my hair. I'm taking some deodorant. This is a cream for my eczema, like face cream. And I'm taking hydrocortisone cream for my eczema and also for my breast in case I'm breastfeeding and it starts feeling like dry or painful. I'll be wearing this in between feedings and just cleaning it out before I feed the baby. I also have some floss. And I have some lip balm, some overnight lip mask, and some lip scrub. Just so I don't want to have like my lips looking all crusty. I'm going to be adding my, I think a pair of magnetic lashes and the magnetic eyeliner and some like basic little bit of makeup just in case for the pictures. And I also need to go ahead and add like a travel size. I need to go and buy the travel size for like body wash. Or if not, one of these to put some body wash inside. So next thing is I am taking two pajamas. The first pajama set that I'm taking is this thermal one. This is in the size small. I got it at Victoria's Secret. The next one that I'm taking is this satin black one from Victoria's Secret as well. And I'm taking two pairs of PJs just because I don't know which I'm going to feel more comfortable in or si me va a dar frío or not. So yeah. Then I'm also taking this undershirt that is to breastfeed. I got this one at Target. This is in the size small, and basically you just have it on, and on the strip se levanta aquí and you're able to breastfeed. And I'll be having this one under my PJs. I like this one because it has a botoncito, so it's going to be more convenient for me to breastfeed. But just in case, if it's cold or whatever, I'll be using this one. It's just nice to have options, especially so you could feel comfortable. So yeah. Next thing is I am taking this little pajama dress. I'm taking this one just in case I want to be on a little dress before delivery or even after, depending how you feel, whatever. And if I use it after, since it's a dress, that's why we have this the shorts. And also for the pajamas, since they have pants, I'm still going to be wearing this under. Again, it's just mainly for comfort preference. And of course, I have this matching robe from the swaddle blanket that my mom gave me. So I'm gonna be, if I'm gonna be on this one, I'm gonna be wearing it. And even if I'm on my other pajamas or whatever, depending like how I feel, I usually like to have something else on. So I'll be having this one. And hopefully, maybe I could even use it for the pictures with the baby to be matching. I bought this Bamboo Bees washable nursing pads. 4 packs of reusable breastfeeding pads. So yeah, on this bag I have 2. This one is the overnight one, which has like more coverage. And you just put it on the section that you need to put it on. And it will absorb whatever milk you're leaking. Once you want to wash it, you can just put it in the washer, whatever. If not, like since I'm going to be there at the hospital, I could just wash it with soap in the sink and just let it air dry. And once this is air drying throughout the day, I have these ones for the day. And like I said, I have 2 pairs on this baggie. But yeah, I got this at Target as well. And this is my mask. I already have the filter in. And I also need to include my towel, which I'm going to be taking, or I'm going to be adding it when I'm ready to go to the hospital. Okay, so for my last baggie is this one. I have 2 more reusable breastfeeding pads. And I just have these 2 over here just in case. You know what? I'm going to add 1 here to have as my to-go outfit, and the other one I'll have it over here with the rest. And this is basically just for me to go home. It's just my clothes to go home. I have it like separado just so that I won't be searching into stuff and making a mess or anything. First thing that I have on my to-go bag is this breastfeeding bra. Again, you unclip it. It's like a sports bra. You unclip it and you're able to breastfeed. Then I have this long sleeve shirt. It's nice and warm. I'll probably have the black undershirt under this one, and then I'll have this one on. I also have my faja for me to be able to go home, and this one is just, it's like a full piece one. It's a size medium, so yeah, and it has a zipper on the side. But yeah, I'll for sure be wearing this one for when I'm leaving the hospital. Then I have these sweatpants that I got at Target. And that is it. So yeah, on this bag, I'm also adding my phone charger, some earphones, just so that I could be watching my phone and not get bored. And I'll be adding obviously my wallet and my inhaler. I should probably add the inhaler already since I have extras. Yeah, so I'll be adding my inhaler, and nomás me lo voy a colgar right here on the little zipper. And any medicine that I need, I'll be putting it in there and taking it with me. So yeah, that is it. I think I got most of the stuff. Most of the hospital stay is 1 to 2 days after you deliver. And before that, you can't really do anything. You're just in bed. So you can't change or go to the restroom, shower, or anything like that. So you don't really need a lot of stuff, at least that's what I think. Of course, if it's a C-section or something like that, then you would stay a little bit longer, which is why I got basically 3 sets of pajamas and stuff like that, just in case the process is a little bit longer. And of course, if I need anything, I'll just tell my husband to bring it in to me, because he is going to be in and out to be at home with the kids and just come and visit for a little bit. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Don't forget to give it a thumbs up, subscribe to my channel, and click on the bell so you could get notified for whenever I post videos. Yeah, so see you guys next time. Bye.